Students, you are most welcome in the online class from Divine Public School. Student, this is my fourth video of class 12, subject economics, chapter number 3, Indian agriculture. Students, in the previous videos, you have read about the reform in Indian agriculture. There are the main three topic of the Indian agriculture for reform. First, technical reforms. Second, institutional reform, and third, general reform. So, technical reform and institutional reform you have already read in the previous videos. Today, we are studying the third topic, general reform. General reform. Students, in the under the this reform come in the fourth reform. First, expansion of irrigations. Expansion of irrigations . Second, provisions of credit. Provisions of credit. Third, regulate market. Regulated market and cooperative marketings. Cooperative marketings, and fourth point is price support policy. Price support policies. Students, the third topics, general instructions, and there are the four topics in under this topic: expansion of the irrigations, provisions of credit, regulated market and cooperative marketing, and price support policy. Students, so now discussion about the first topics. First topic is expansion of the irrigations facilities, your irrigations facilities. Student, with your views of the promoting and establishing productivities in agriculture's irrigation facilities have been expanded. Several major and minor irrigation projects have been launched across the different parts of the country in 1951. Students, barely 17% of the lands was under permanent mean of the irrigation. 1951, only 17% facilities to irrigation facility available in the country. So now irrigation is cover about 45%, and 2014 and 15 is a 45% area covering the irrigation systems in the nowadays. 2014 and 15. So, students, lands of under cultivations, area under irrigations has increased mainly owing to the construction of multi-purpose major and two wells and multi-purpose projects finance. Dry farming techniques and have been introduced in area where irrigation is not possible. I know you know that without irrigation system we cannot produce of the crops. So that is very important to the expansion of the irrigation facilities, very important for country. And second point is provisions of credit. Students, cooperative credit society has been set up to provide credit to the farmers. At present, there are 94,647 primary agriculture credit societies and 768 primary cooperative agriculture and rural development banks in the country. Students, that is very important for 94,647 primary agriculture credit and 768 cooperative rural development areas banks. After nationalizations, commercial banks have been catering to the credit need of the farmers. These banks provide about 72% of the total institutional credit. Regions, rural banks have been established to the further enhance credit facilities. And in 1982, the establishment of the National Banks of Agriculture and Rural Development, means NABARD, was established to the institutionalized credit facilities to the farmer at the national levels in the 2013-14. Flow of the institutional credit to the farmers was estimated to before the raise 7,30,765 crore rupees. And so next topic is, students, regulate market and cooperative marketing societies. Regulate market have been established across all parts of the countries. This is the few of the views of offering remunerative price of the farmer and protect them against exploitations by the middlemen and their government's representative to of the farmer are also members. These committees ensure timely payment to the farmer and also ensure that only a specified weight and a measure are used to the weight and value the farmer and produce. Cooperative marketing societies have been established to the enhance of the bargaining power of the farmer in the market. These societies ensure that the farmer produces graded and sold only when remunerative price in the available. And students, they are the fourth points, price supports policy. To motivate the farmer to the increase farm's output, it is necessary to protect them against uncertainties to the market. There has come the role of the price supports policies. Under the policies, government ensure a minimum price to the farmer for the produce. The government is committed to buy the surplus produce of the farmer of the minimum supports price. So minimum price support is the establish and engage to the farmer to growth of their the productions, and they as the maximum they will do the maximum production of their crops. And this topic, students, reform is a very important topics. Here are the green revolution. Green revolution is very important factor to growth of the production of crops, especially for the Punjab, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. And Mr. Swaminathan is an Indian farmer, father of the green revolutions. Mr. Swaminathan is called the father of the green revolutions. So green revolution is very important factor to technology for growth of the crop productions. The agriculture's productivity on the eve of the independence was very low. The main reasons for this low agriculture productivity was the use of old and outdated technology in the agriculture sector. Hence, after independence, the traditional agriculture's practices were replaced by the modern technology in Indian agriculture. This new agricultural technology consisted to the use of the high yielding varieties, HYV, seeds, chemicals, fertilizers, pesticides, extensive irrigations, and modern agriculture implements. Now, agriculture technology has suggested use the package inputs, the simulations, and the coordinated use of the HYV seeds cannot increase agriculture productivity until and unless it is the supports by irrigation facilities, chemical fertilizers, and pesticides. The core elements of new agriculture technology in high yielding variety seeds, because it increases the productivity of lands after the adaptation of the new agriculture technology. And we notice the sudden spurts in the food gains production in 1967 to 68. This boost up, just like is the revolutions in the history of Indian agriculture, and that is the wise team to green revolutions, growing regions only. Impact of the green revolutions. What impact of the green revolutions? Impact of green revolution in our productions. First, increase our benefit of productivities. By adopting new agriculture technology, green revolutions has increased the per hectare productivities of major cereals, especially wheat and rice. As a result of this, the output of foods, grains in the countries has increased tremendously since the vaccine enables India to achieve self-sufficient in food grains. So, dear students, second impact is accumulation of surplus produce. Students, the farmer of Indian are following multi-crop program since 1967-68, which enables use to the raise huge buffer stocks of food grains. Buffer stocks of the food grains can be used in times of the shortage, and thus India has improved the food security systems. Thus, green revolutions helped in achieving self-sufficiency, one of the long-term goal of the planning. And third, shift from the subsistence farming of the commercial farming. It is increased to the commercialized of the agriculture. In agriculture, green revolutions has also changed the pattern of the agriculture. Now agriculture is practiced not only self-consumption, rather than has the come of the commercials proportions. As a result, in increased agriculture output, means maximum output increase in the causes of the green revolutions. And then after, facility to the restriction to limitation crop and areas, and maximum or special for the wheats, rice, and mustard seeds, very effective of these the crops. So student, this is the today's end of this chapter, Indian agriculture. Students, maximum questions come from the NCERTs. NCERTs is maximum question to topic given in this is given these topics. like reform of the agriculture is very important topic. Reform of the agriculture, that is very important topic. Problem of Indian agriculture is also important maybe, but maximum important, most important to how can reform of the Indian agricultures. So that is very important topic for NCERT questions. So you study these topics, learn this topic and make in notes also, and repeat NCERT questions. Like NCERT questions, maximum question come from this topic. It's like a questions. What are high yielding variety seeds? The question may be NCERT question also. This question is, what are high yielding, means HYB seeds? Students, HYB seeds are called the miracle seeds, as these seeds led to the revolution rise of the production per hectares. So that is very short answer, but a long answer is given in the lecture. And you once again look this lecture and write the answer also. Next question also, what is your marketable surplus? Students, a question is very important for the examinations. Actually, it is the NCERT question also. Question is, what do you mean about the marketable surplus? Important topics. Students, it refers to surplus of farmers output over and above his own farm consumptions. Thus, marketable surplus of wheat is equal to output of wheat and farm consumption of the wheat. The surplus is available to the farmers for sale in the market, hence called marketable surplus. By selling the marketable surplus, he gets cash. He can use this cash to buy producer goods for the further production, and also to buy consumer goods for his the current consumptions. Marketable surplus is assigned to commercialization of agriculture. Students, maximum farmer is not only for consumption produce of the crops, he also sold on the markets. So those remain of the consumption to the farmer and sold in the markets, or sell in the market as earn some cash, earn for currency, and this currency used in the our necessary commodities, purchase the necessary commodities. So this type of situation called the marketable surplus. Students, so that is some important question. And next question, explain the need and type of the land reform employment in the agriculture sector. As a discussion about before chapters, videos. And what is green revolutions? That is very important question. What is green revolutions? What was implemented and how did the benefit the farmer? Explain the brief. So this is also explained. Green revolution definitions and what effect in the benefit of the farmer. So the production of the crops and new facilities obtain the like pesticides, fertilizers, insecticides, much more. So that is these are the NCERT questions. So students, I suggest that you learn this question answer, and I hope more to more practice on this question answer. Thank you.